Now we are going to see the demonstration of a photodiode experiment. Here in this experiment we are going to find the VI characteristics of a photodiode in the reverse bias and also calculate the power responsivity. This is a photodiode built in board. It consists of a voltmeter, digital, microammeter. Here this is a connections voltmeter to voltmeter, ammeter to ammeter, and this is a photodiode here. There is, apart from this board, we have another setup where the photodiode is fixed here. This is having values of intensity of light here. It has photodiode power is, photo power of a photodiode is, you can measure 10. There is a knob here, 10, 11, 12. Like that you can vary the power given to a photodiode. Make it to 10. Now switch on the circuit. You can see that this is a light LED, light emitting diode, this, and this is a photodiode. This light given out by LED is taken by the photodiode, and this photodiode characteristics we are seeing on the board. Now if you see here, this is off, this is on, and the amount of light is being controlled here. If you increase the intensity here, if you increase the power of LED, the intensity of the light increases, and if you decrease, it is decreasing. Okay, this is a photodiode, and now there is a cap overhead over this here, which says that only the light given out from the LED is being taken by the photodiode, and this, the power of LED, power of PLED is given by the grad. You can make out here PLED 10, 20. This is in milliwatts. Now we are going to see the connections. Since there is no connection here, connect the circuit, connect a wire here between these two. And again these two. Connect voltmeter to voltmeter. In this experiment, we are going to see the VI characteristics of a photodiode in the reverse bias characteristics. Now, ammeter to, this is a ammeter, this has to be connected to micro ammeter. And here, photodiode from this kit, we are connecting to the photodiode. It is connected in the reverse bias. So the connections are here, clear here. This is a photodiode, this is ammeter, this is a voltmeter, and they are connections. And now we are said that this is the knob which increases the voltage here. We can make it to 0, 0. Now the initial readings are, voltmeter is 0, micrometer is 0, and here we have kept PLED as 10. PLED is set to P. Power given to LED is set to 10 milliwatts. Now we need to start the readings. This is the tabular column which we need to fill. Here, see, for the initial reading is light given to the photodiode. It is 0. It is, we have written as 0. PLED we have set it to 10 milliwatts. Now increase the voltage in steps of 0.1. And note down the corresponding PLED, microammeter reading here. Okay, so for 0.1 we will see what is the reading. Vary this knob here. If you vary this, the voltage also increases. For 0.1, for 0.1 voltmeter, you see the corresponding.
0.118.
It will come to 0.1, it is 0.14. Okay, make it as 0.132. You are getting, write it as 32. Next, you like that we have measured here 0.1 as 32. Next we will make it as 0.2 and note down the corresponding micrometer readings. Note it down. For 0.2 the value is corresponding micrometer reading is 62. Next make it as 0.3.
for 0.3 make it as 147. Like that you keep on increasing the values for 0.4, 0.5. Like that note down the readings and tabulate the columns. Similarly, when you go increase the values of voltage by 0.1, 0.2, the corresponding ammeter readings have been noted down. Now after doing this, bring it back to 0 and make the PLED, make it to 20. Here it is 18, next is 21, you can make it as 21. Now PLED is kept at 21. Now here we are taking PLED as 21 milliwatts and note down the corresponding values. For 0 it will be 0. Now you keep on increasing the values of voltage and note down the corresponding PLED. So now start with 0.1, it is 0.1, it is coming to 30, you can take it 30. Next make it to 0.2, note down the corresponding, make for 0.2, note down the corresponding ammeter reading, it is 84. Similarly keep on increasing to 0.3 and note down the tabulate the readings in the tabular column. Similarly for PLED as 21 milliwatts, note down the corresponding microammeter for the corresponding changes in the voltage. Keep on increasing the voltage by 0.1, note down the corresponding values. Similarly change PLED for 30, 40 and 50 and keep on changing the values of voltage, note down the corresponding ammeter readings. Now these are the tabulated readings. We have seen for PLED set for 10, we have taken the readings. PLED set for 21, we have taken the readings. 30, taken the readings. 38, we have taken the readings. After taking these readings, we have to plot a graph. This is a reverse bias characteristics. So all the old values here, all the values will be reverse bias. It is reverse bias means it is a negative values we will be getting. So this is a reverse bias, so we need to plot a graph both current and voltage in the third quadrant. Here the voltage is taken along the x axis 0.1, 0.2 because reverse voltage, so we are getting minus values, and similarly the current also becomes negative because it is a negative reverse bias. Plot a graph. If you plot a graph between the voltage and current what we have taken, this is for PLED 10, this is for 20, this is for 30, this is for 40 and this is for 50. Since it is a reverse bias characteristics, we are taking both the current also negative values and voltage also taken as negative values, and we are plotting a graph. These are the reverse bias characteristics of a. Now we are going to start with the calculate the power responsivity. Here we are going to keep the voltage as 1 volt, vary PLED and note down the corresponding IPD. Now we will see how. Now to calculate the power responsivity, keep the voltage at 1 volt, 0.9. We are keeping the voltage at 1. This remains fixed. We are keeping the voltage 1. Now vary the PLED. Now we are keeping PLED at 10. Note down the corresponding ammeter reading here, micrometer reading, that is 308. Now see, we have done the tabulated the reading for PLED 10, noting down current as 308. Now we will go with PLED 12. Keep the PLED as 12. Here PLED is 12. Note down the corresponding micrometer reading, it is 368. Next, keep the PLED to 14. Note down the corresponding current, it is 418. Similarly, you have to take the readings for 16, 18 and 20. And now tabulate the readings. Now we have tabulated the readings for keeping voltage as 1 volt, vary PLED, note down the corresponding current. Now we have to plot a graph for this. PLED on x-axis and IPD on y-axis. Now if you plot a graph where PLED is on x-axis and YPD along the x-axis, if you plot the points, you get a straight line. The slope of it gives you the responsivity. Responsivity is nothing but delta IPD by delta PLED, that is difference in the Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. Take the values, you will be getting the responsivity. Whatever you get the value of the slope, that becomes the responsivity. So here, this is the PLED along x-axis, IPD along the y-axis, the slope of it gives you the responsivity. So the result is, studied the photodiode characteristics in the reverse bias condition and we have got the power sensitivity as 13.3 milliamps per watt. This is the responsivity of a given photodiode. Thank you.